नमस्ते बिटिया, हमेशा खुश रहो। आई एम जेवीएन डॉक्टर सुमन शेखावत, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ काय चिकित्सा, फैकल्टी ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक साइंसेज, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, विमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑन कार्डियोवैस्कुलर सिस्टम एग्जामिनेशन दैट वी शुड आस्क द पेशेंट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हिस्ट्री ऑफ द पेशेंट दैट सम काइंड ऑफ सिम्टम्स प्रेजेंट टू द पेशेंट और नॉट, लाइक कार्डिनल सिम्टम, डिस्निया ऑन एग्जर्शन और ब्रीथलेसनेस including paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea, orthopnea, platypnea, treponema and chest pain, cough, expectoration, hemoptysis, palpitation, syncopal attack, symptoms of congestive cardiac failure like exertional breathlessness, edema of the feet, puffiness of face, anasarca, distension of abdomen and pain in right hypochondrium, anorexia, nausea, vomiting, symptoms of rheumatic heart disease like fever with sore throat, fleeting joint pain, swelling, involuntary chorea, nodules under the skin like rheumatic nodule, symptoms of infective endocarditis, SBE. These all are symptoms present in the patient or not, we should ask with the patient, like pyrexia, tracheal hemorrhage, pads of the finger, osteolar nodes, palpable spleen, phalangeal clubbing, prolonged treatment with high dose of penicillin. We should ask with the patient that patient is taking prolonged treatment of penicillin or not, hemoptysis, hematuria, hemiplegia, phlebothrombosis, symptoms of suggestive congenital heart disease, patient have or not like cyanotic spell, squatting episodes and pressure symptom due to enlarged left atrium or aneurysm of aorta like hoarseness of voice, pressure on the recurrent laryngeal nerve, Ortrus syndrome, dysphagia, pressure on esophagus, miscellaneous symptoms, some of miscellaneous things we should ask with the patient, like family history, hypertension, diabetes, coronary artery disease, dyslipidemia, congenital heart disease, cardiomyopathies, and past history of hypertension, diabetes, coronary artery disease, hyperlipidemia, obesity, recurrent lower respiratory infection, tuberculosis, syphilis, STD, HIV and infection, history of hospitalization, number of admissions, duration of each admission and investigation done like ECG, X-ray, echocardiography, cardiac catheterization, diagnosis reached if known, drug given example diuretics, digitalis, relief obtained or not, advice surgery intervention or not, history of cardiac surgery, angioplasty or volvuloplasty. We should ask with the physical examination or general examination of the patient, like we have to see in the patient that build and nutrition of the patient, nails in conjunctiva for pallor, icterus, clubbing and cyanosis, lymphadenopathy and thyroid swelling, edema, skin for tracheal hemorrhage, osteolar nodes, rheumatic nodules, xanthelasma and xanthomas. We should ask with the patient skeletal system, kyphoscoliosis and polydactyly, decubitus temperature, pulse and respiratory rate, blood pressure of the patient, features of Marfan syndrome, that patient have these kind of symptoms or not. If patient have these kind of symptoms, we should assess the patient. And cardiovascular system, first of all we should see that we have to examine in cardiovascular system, like peripheral and central things. Peripheral we should examine jugular venous pressure and pulse, रेट, रिदम, वॉल्यूम, कैरेक्टर, क्वालिटी, अपस्ट्रोक, डाउनस्ट्रोक, कंडीशन ऑफ वेसल वॉल, अपेक्स, पल्स डेफिशिट एंड रेडियो फिमोरल डिले, कैरोटिड रूट, ब्लड प्रेशर, बोथ आर्म सुपाइन एंड अपराइट, पेरिफेरल साइन ऑफ वाइड पल्स प्रेशर एज इन AI, PDA, एटसेट्रा, पिस्टल शॉट साउंड्स ओवर द फिमोरल मुसेट साइन, डी मुसेट साइन, लोकोमोटर ब्रेकियल. सेंट्रली वी शुड सी इंस्पेक्शन, पाल्पेशन, परकशन एंड ऑस्कल्टेशन. वी शुड सी इन इंस्पेक्शन प्रिकॉर्डियल, प्रिकॉर्डियम, अपेक्स इम्पल्स, अदर पल्सेशन, पैरास्टर्नल एपिसोड्स एंड पाल्पेशन. वी शुड सी अपेक्स बीट एंड परकशन. वी शुड सी राइट अपर बॉर्डर एंड राइट बॉर्डर, लेफ्ट बॉर्डर, लोअर स्टर्नल रेजोनेंस. ऑस्कल्टेशन वी शुड सी हार्ट साउंड, मर्मर एंड अदर साउंड. नमस्ते बिटिया, हमेशा खुश रहो. आई एम JVN डॉक्टर, डॉक्टर सुमन शेखावत, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ काय चिकित्सा, फैकल्टी ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक साइंसेस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, विमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑन कार्डियोवैस्कुलर सिस्टम मैनुअल पार्ट 4. Arterial pulses should be palpated for evaluation of rate, rhythm and character and symmetry. Rate and rhythm. By convention, both rate and rhythm are assessed by palpating the right radial pulse rate expressed in beat per minute, BPM, is measured by counting the number of beat in a timed period of 15 seconds and multiplying by 4. Normal sinus rhythm is regular, but in young patient may show phasic variation in rate during respiration. Sinus arrhythmias and irregular rhythms usually indicate atrial fibrillation, but may also be caused by frequent ectopic beats or self-limiting paroxysmal arrhythmias. In patient with atrial fibrillation, the rate should be measured by auscultation at the cardiac apex, because beats that follow very short diastolic interval may create a pulse deficit by not generating sufficient pressure to the palpable at the radial artery. Character is defined by the volume and waveform of the pulse and should be evaluated at the right carotid artery. Example, the pulse closest to the heart and least subject to damping and distortion in the arterial tree. Pulse volume provides a crude indication of stroke volume being small in heart failure and large in aortic regurgitation. The waveform of the pulse is of greater diagnostic importance. Symmetry of the radial, brachial, carotid, femoral, popliteal and pedal pulses should be confirmed. A reduced or absent pulse indicate an obstruction more proximally in the arterial tree, usually caused by atherosclerosis and thromboembolism, and less commonly by aortic dissection. Coarctation of the aorta causes symmetrical reduction and delay of the femoral pulses compared with the radial pulses. Radiofemoral delay, a sign that should be looked for a younger patient with hypertension. Bruit from collateral vessel may also be heard over the
back of the patient. Measurement of blood pressure. The principle of manual blood pressure measurement is the turbulent flow through a partially compressed artery. Typically, the brachial creates noise that can be auscultated with a stethoscope, and the point at which these noise called Korotkov sound. Change in intensity correlate with systemic arterial pressure. Accurate blood pressure measurement requires careful technique. Patient should be sitting or lying at ease as significant changes in arterial pressure occurs with exertion, anxiety, and change in posture. The manometer should be at the same level of the cuff on the patient's arm and the observer's eye. For most adult patients, a standard cuff 12 centimeter width is appropriate, but obese subjects require use of a wider thigh cuff of 15 centimeter or the blood pressure will be overestimated. Palpate the radial pulse as the cuff is inflated to a pressure of 20 mm of Hg above the level at which radial pulsation can no longer be felt. Place the stethoscope lightly over the brachial artery and reduce the pressure in the cuff at a rate of 2 to 3 mm of Hg is until the first sound are heard. This is the first Korotkov sound and correlate with systolic blood pressure. As flow is just possible through the pressure applies by the compressive cuff, as the pressure is lowered, further subtle change in the pitch and volume occurs. These are the second and third Korotkov sound and are not important clinically, with further lowering of the pressure in the cuff, the artery becomes less compressed, flow becomes less turbulent, and the sound over the brachial artery become muffled. This is the fourth Korotkov sound. Shortly after this, usually 1 to 10 mm Hg lower, the sound dies away completely as flow is unimpeded by the cuff. This is the fifth Korotkov sound and correlate most accurately with diastolic blood pressure. Its identification is also less subjective than the fourth, but in some condition, aortic regurgitation, arteriovenous fistula, pregnancy, the Korotkov sound remains audible despite complete deflation of the cuff. In such situation, phase 4 must be used for the diastolic measurement. Both systolic and diastolic values are recorded. The difference between these two values is called the pulse pressure. Certain condition of the aortic valve may cause important abnormalities of pulse pressure. Supine and erect blood pressure measurement provide an assessment of baroreceptor function, a postural drop being defined by a fall in the systolic blood pressure or on standing. It is essential to work swiftly as well as accurately, as compression of a limb will be itself cause a rise in blood pressure if several successive measurements are made. The air pressure in the cuff should be allowed to fall to zero between reading. Jugular venous pressure fluctuation in right atrial pressure during the cardiac cycle generate pulse that is transmitted backward into the jugular vein. It is best examined in good light while the patient recline at 45 degree. If the right atrial pressure is very low, however, visualization of the jugular venous pulse may require a smaller reclining angle. Alternatively, manual pressure over the upper right side the abdomen may be used to produce a transient increasing in venous return to the heart, which elevates the jugular venous pressure. Hepatojugular reflexes. Jugular venous pressure. The jugular venous pressure JVP should be assessed from the waveform of the internal jugular vein, which lies adjacent to the medial border of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Distension of the external jugular vein is a useful clue to an elevated JVP, but strictly speaking should not be used, because it can be compressed as it passes under the clavicle. The JVP is measured in centimeter vertically from the sternal angle to the top of the venous waveform. The normal upper limit is 4 cm. This is about 9 cm above the right atrium and correspond to a pressure of 6 mm of Hg. Elevation of the JVP indicate a raised right atrial pressure unless the superior vena cava is obstructed, producing engorgement of the neck veins during inspiration. Inspiration, the pressure within the chest decreases and there is a fall in the JVP. In constrictive pericarditis and less commonly in tamponade, inspiration produced a paradoxical rise in the JVP, Kussmaul sign, because the increased venous return that occurs during inspiration can't be accommodated within the constrained right side of the heart. Causes of elevated JVP is jugular venous pressure, congestive heart failure, core pulmonary embolism, right ventricular infarction, tricuspid valve disease, tamponade, constrictive pericarditis, hypertrophic restrictive cardiomyopathy. Causes of elevated jugular venous pressure, congestive heart failure, core pulmonary embolism, right ventricular infarction, tricuspid valve disease, tamponade, constrictive pericarditis, hypertrophic restrictive cardiomyopathy, superior vena cava obstruction, iatrogenic fluid overload, and particularly in surgical renal patient. Palpation of the chest wall. The apex beat is defined as the lowest and most lateral point at which the cardiac impulses can be palpated. Inferior or lateral displacement from its normal location in the fifth intercostal space in the midclavicular line usually indicate cardiac enlargement, chronic volume loading of the left ventricle, mitral regurgitation, aortic regurgitation causes left ventricle dilatation, which can be appreciated clinically. In contrast, isolated pressure loading of the left ventricle, hypertension, aortic stenosis causes left ventricular hypertrophy, which doesn't cause displacement of the apex beat. Palpable third and fourth heart sound give the apical impulse a double thrust. In the past, considerable importance was attached टू द कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ द एपिकल इम्पल्स. थ्रस्टिंग इन एओर्टिक वॉल्व डिजीज, टैपिंग इन मिट्रल स्टेनोसिस, बट दिस इज ऑफ वेरी लिमिटेड प्रैक्टिकल वैल्यू इन द मॉडर्न एरा. लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल्स एन्यूरिज्म कैन समटाइम बी पल्पेटेड मीडियल टू द कार्डियक अपेक्स. राइट वेंट्रिकुलर एनलार्जमेंट प्रोड्यूस अ सिस्टोलिक थ्रस्ट हीव इन द लेफ्ट पैरास्टर्नल एरिया. द टर्बुलेंट फ्लो रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मर्मर्स में प्रोड्यूस पाल्पेबल वाइब्रेशन थ्रिल्स ऑन द चेस्ट वॉल, पर्टिकुलरली इन एओर्टिक स्टेनोसिस, वेंट्रिकुलर सेप्टल डिफेक्ट एंड पेटेंट डक्टस आर्ट्रियोसिस. सम ऑफ क्वेश्चन इन दिस सेशन लाइक हाउ मेनी कोरोकॉफ साउंड आर डिस्क्राइब्ड विच इज नॉट अ कॉज ऑफ JVP. दिस सेशन इज पावर्ड बाय डिजिटल वर्जन 2.0 ज्योति विद्यापीठ विमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. आई होप यू ऑल आर सेटिस्फाइड विद दिस सेशन. इफ यू हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम विद दिस सेशन, प्लीज मेंशन इट इन कॉमेंट बॉक्स. आई विल रिजॉल्व इट सून. थैंक यू.